Hey everyone. So I just wanted to show what I've been working on recently. It's a high frequency vacuum tube Tesla coil. It's based on a existing piece of industrial equipment, which I'm assuming came out of some type of radio frequency heating system or some type of plasma mass spectrometer of some type, but I haven't been able to find any sort of documentation associated with it. The only parts I added onto this were this vacuum capacitor, which I don't even think is necessary because it doesn't seem to make any difference to the output, regardless of how it's adjusted. I simply added it on there just because I had it and I thought it would make it easier to tune the circuit, but it doesn't seem to make any difference. So, in the final build, I'm just going to remove that. Just have the feedback connection connected directly to the feedback capacitor that's down there. I fabricated this bracket and the mount for the resonator coil that I just wound up out of a copper tube. It's no real specification. It's just about 16 turns. Came out to about 8 microhenries of inductance. Breakout point is just a sharpened piece of metal. I'll flip this over so we can take a look at what's inside. So, just inside, we basically have everything needed for this type of circuit. We have the tube socket, which was the most important part for me. High voltage feed-throughs, grid leakage components, choke, resistor, diode. Down there we have the input filter capacitor. Over there was just the interlock switch, which I just cut out. Basically everything needed to get this circuit to work. So you just made some simple connections to the coil here. Copper straps for the RF connections. Right here is the RF choke for the input voltage supply. And for the power supply, I'm just using a modified microwave oven inverter, only modified to have a positive output, which all I did to do that was clip out the diodes and just flip them around and solder them back in. So it gives me positive 4,000 volts output. Filament transformer is just wound down a toroidal transformer, which makes the construction very simple, which gives me an output of 6.3 volts to the filament. In order to control the output of the microwave oven inverter board, we have a PWM frequency generator, which comes in handy. It's just connected to a 9-volt battery. I have the output set at 60 hertz, and then we can just change the duty cycle just like that, which controls the power of the microwave inverter. I have a cooling fan set up. So I got the cooling fan engaged. I'll remove my safety clip. I'll turn on my little spectrum analyzer so we can take a look at the frequency. and turn on the filament. You can hear it humming away. Now I'll go ahead and increase the power of the inverter. At the same time, we'll look at the spectrum analyzer so we can see what the output is. There we go, just kicked in. I'm gonna go ahead and change the scale on this so we can see it. We're at around 20 megahertz. Right there. 18% duty cycle. So I'll increase power input until we get our discharge. There we go. Nice flame discharge. Self-ignites. Well, let me know what you think of that. I'm going to build this into a nice enclosure for the fan, inverter, filament supply. I'm probably going to eliminate this from the final build because it doesn't really make a difference. And I'll show that when that's completed.